You're listening to Bodhi Light Tales, the podcast for mindful people on the go. Hello, this is Miao Guang. Today's Bodhi Light Tale is Nudist Country. Once upon a time, there lived two brothers, Jordan and Oliver. The two ran a business together, and each had their products to sell. Thinking about expanding their business, the two of them traveled out of town. Soon, they arrived at the border of a nudist country. Oliver said to his elder brother, "Did you know that people here don't wear clothes? It's their social custom, very different from ours." Jordan replied, "No, I didn't know that. And we must remember that no matter where we go in this country, we shouldn't forget our manners and courtesy. We should never forgo our virtue and conduct. You agree?" Oliver said, "Yes, yes. But if we're thinking of selling our products here, we need to understand our customers. So to understand them, we need to do as the natives do." Jordan, disapproving, said, "What do you mean to do as the natives do? Being nude in public? This is against our code of conduct." Oliver tried to convince Jordan, "Many of the ancient sages, though they may have changed their appearance, they remain true to their customs and beliefs. I don't think if we do what they did, we are losing ourselves. Our beliefs will still hold true." Jordan, after thinking about it, said, "All right, how about you go and try out the market first? Please let me know what the situation is after you've checked things out." So Oliver entered the nudist country. For one whole week, he tried to understand the local customs while also trying to sell his products. After 2 weeks, Oliver sent a message to Jordan. "Dear brother, I am doing well. I have learned so much about their customs and what we can do to succeed. Everything must follow local customs, and they'll like our products for sure." When he got the message, Jordan was unhappy and thought, "Why should we change ourselves to become like them? We're not animals. We're meant to wear clothes and not go around naked. How is this meant to be the conduct of a gentleman? I won't do what Oliver is doing." In the nudist country, it was custom that twice a month, on the 1st and 15th day of the lunar calendar, for people to rub oil on their bodies, then apply a coating of white clay, and wear all kinds of accessories. Men and women would dance and sing hand in hand to the tune of two stones banging against each other. Oliver had no problem in blending in with the local customs. He dressed like them, joining the locals singing and dancing. As a result, everyone in the nudist country, regardless of age, adored Oliver. Within a month, Oliver managed to sell all of his products. His profits were 10 times more than he expected. Soon after Jordan arrived in the nudist country, still holding strong to his traditional values, he felt very righteous. He went around criticizing the people of the nudist country. Everywhere he went, he made the locals very angry. Soon the king heard about him and ordered his ministers to arrest Jordan. Jordan ended up in jail and his products were confiscated. When Oliver found out, he went to see the king and pleaded for the release of his brother. The king said to Jordan, "You're lucky to have a brother like Oliver. He's much welcomed in our country because he accepted us for who we are. He became one of us, and we are very happy to have him as a part of our community. But you, on the other hand, never took the time to understand us, and you only criticize. I will now free you, but please go back to your country and never return." The day after, Jordan and Oliver were ready to leave the nudist country. Everyone hugged Oliver, giving him gifts as they bade him farewell. When they saw Jordan, they were still angry, and some even went up to Jordan and lectured him. Jordan, still feeling he was better than them, knew better and said nothing. There is a Buddhist philosophy regarding a sense of fellowship. This means to step into the shoes of others, to use skillful means most acceptable to the other person. Naturally, the other person will accept and change. In the Universal Gate chapter on Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, it states that the Bodhisattva has 32 manifestations, that whatever form a person is most likely to receive the Dharma, Avalokiteshvara will manifest in that form to teach the Dharma. This is the sense of fellowship referred to earlier. Likewise, in our daily lives, regardless of whether it is parents teaching the children, or teachers guiding students, or managers leading their team, if we can be like Avalokiteshvara and foster a sense of fellowship when helping others, not only will our help be accepted, but it will move them as well. In this story, Jordan was not flexible enough to make new changes, while Oliver's actions were warmly received by the locals when doing business with them. His words and products were widely accepted by the people because he joined in with the local customs, whereas Jordan did not, and his criticism caused conflict and misunderstanding. Oliver's actions could be seen as an embodiment of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, who appeared in a form suited to the needs of the people. Oliver was willing to adjust to a new way of communication, to form an affinity with the locals. By doing so, people opened up to him and welcomed him with open arms. We need to see that we are not separate from others. We are all interconnected in some way, shape, or form. Though we may have different backgrounds, we need to respect and accept others as they are. Just as Venerable Master Hsing Yun says, the success of all depends on harmonious communication. The key to communication and harmony is mutual respect.
This is Miao Guang. Thank you for listening to Bodhi Light Tales. Subscribe to us and have stories delivered to you every week. May your day be filled with happiness and wisdom.